The Capstone Engineering class is a great class that teaches us the whole culmination of the last 4 years of school here.
Taking everything you've learned, all the math, all the science, coming up with a project, putting it into practice.
Anywhere from being a plant manager or working on a production line or doing your own designing, you're going to be a part of a team, and that's what Capstone really captivates for me.
Our team is team number one, and we are building an SCP assistive globe.
Our team is Team 6A Adaptive Technologies, and we are making the Outrigger ski pole.
For Capstone Engineering, our team number is 24, and our team name is 3D Med.
We're team 10, and we are working on the H2 Cool device.
Work with High Fives Foundation to come up with an adaptive technology ski pole that's used by disabled skiers on the mountains. So we've made sure that with our ski pole, we have a lot more upgradable systems on it. It's safer for the user to use. It has a suspension system to reduce the impact on the user's arms and joints. And we have to make sure that it's more cost efficient and friendly for the user itself.
For our Capstone project, we were sponsored by the School of Medicine to build them a 3D printer specifically for building 3D casts. The idea behind our design was to get rid of the Cartesian bed, that plain flat bed you see on most 3D printers, and to create a cylindrical bed that would give us the shapes from the get-go. This will give you a stronger cast, this is for hospital settings, and it will reduce time between you and the doctor when you actually visit.
Our team was interested in soft robotics, so and taking a relatively new technology such as the SCP actuators and turning it into a practical application. When we looked at these new artificial muscles, I mean, the first thing that everyone thinks of is Iron Man. And our group was really excited and thought, well, maybe we could make something to augment a user's grip strength. So the idea is that it'd be able to help the individuals with hand disabilities possibly be used in industrial applications where there's a grip fatigue.
So what we wanted to do is create a device that you could attach to your bicycle or mountain bike that on long rides would keep your beverage cool so that when you're sweating, you can have a nice refreshing beverage. So you have a self-contained device that will keep a beverage cold. And how it works is it's a battery operated device that has a thermoelectric cooler that chills the shell that your water bottle sits inside. So it pulls that heat out of the system and ejects it behind you.
A few good milestones for us were definitely the welding aspect of the spring into the suspension system, the molding of the ski itself, which we have found a couple errors in there, but it's just stuff to learn on. And then another thing was just printing the arm cuff and all that stuff and making sure it all comes together. And then seeing a product in hand is a great feeling as a team. Working in the University of Nevada engineering program has definitely helped me find a job and stay in a job, due to just their great teachers and knowledge of everything I've learned over the past 5 years.
The professor that we were working with, Jun Zhang, one of the things that he was really wanting was for us to show off the SCP actuators in general, because they're an emerging technology that really has some potential both in medical and soft robotic fields. The engineering program really helped me out both in getting me the experience that I needed to get a job right after college, as well as the research experience, which gave me hands-on work to really stand apart from everyone else who was applying for that job.
Most Capstone engineering projects might be around 40 to 50 pieces, even smaller. I knew a team that only had one or two pieces. Ours is roughly 1,000 pieces to put together. For the initial few tests of our machine, it's just gonna be to see if we can print a cylinder, see if we can make that ring shape, then we'd probably go into making a spring elongation, advertising that our machine can build the cast, and we wanna prove that. Through networking here at the university, I was able to obtain my internship at Aqua Metals and landed a permanent position after graduation. I actually can't wait for after graduation and start as a real engineer somewhere. It's actually really exciting.